Sitaram, and warm welcome to everyone to the three-night satsang. Today is the second night of the satsang, and on behalf of my father, Padlo Rupnarain, grandfather, Ramdev Rupnarain, grandmother, Bisunde Rupnarain, and all family members, we wish to show appreciation for your attendance here tonight. My father, Padlo Rupnarain, welcomed his 60th birthday recently, and as a tribute to Bhagwan, it was his wish to give thanks to God for all the blessings he received for his family and himself. It was his desire to host a satsang to pay tribute to God, and he is blessed to have three renowned pandits to host these three nights: Pandit Parasram Maharaj, Pandit Abedinand Prasad Sharma, and Pandit Navin Umardat Maharaj. My father has worked very hard, and the knowledge he gained came from the scriptures he learned from his parents. My family is deep-rooted in religion and culture, and they have made many contributions to society to foster the teachings of the scriptures. The reason for this is to inspire the youth to promote the teachings as their legacy. More so, for each night, their wish is to ensure that the younger generation learn and practice religion actively and not let it wither. During the devotion tonight, we seek to attain the blessings for all, including the ancestors and departed souls. Last night, Pandit Parasram Maharaj enlightened and enriched the audience with the knowledge of the rituals performed by the devotees of Hinduism and the need to follow the teachings of the scriptures. Thank you, Panditji, for your inspirational words last night. For tonight's session, I want to welcome Pandit Abedinand Prasad Sharma, who will officiate today's reading, the special guest, Mr. Dave Sibalak, and his family, Mr. Ram Logan, the former CEO of the Transport Board, and Mr. Sipasad from Sipasad Hardware, and Mr. Norris, the members of the congregation, accompanying musicians and singers from the Chinmaya Gyan Kirtan Mandali group, members of the media houses. Thank you, and Sitaram.
Prem se boliye Gajanand Swami ki jai, Umapati Mahadev ki jai, Pavan Sut Hanuman ki jai, Aaj Shakti Jagadamba Durga Devi Mata ki jai. Please stand as we join once again on this the second night of this three night satsang, glorifying and praising our Lord and Divine Master with faith, with love and with devotion. We meditate upon the divine form of Bhagwan Shri Ganesh as we pray, asking him to guide us through the night and every second and every moment of our lives. Sarvakarishu sarvada Om Yakundendu tusharahar dhavala Yashubra vastravrata Yavina varadanda manditkara Yashweta padmasana Shankara Prabhritibhi Devai Sada Vandita Samam Patu Saraswati Bhagavati Nishresh Jarvyapaha Om Akanda Mandala Karam Vyaptam Yena Characharam Padam Darshitam Nena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Everyone, as we think of our beloved Guru, we bow to his lotus-like feet this evening, and we pray that may his blessing manifest in our lives in the form of knowledge. Om Guru Brahma Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwarah, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Shri Anubhavanandaya Namaha, Om Shri Chinmayanandaya Namaha, Om Shri Gurudattaya Namaha, Om Shri Satya Saishwaraya Namaha, Om Tapovanaya Namaha, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Salutations to the lotus feet of the blue boy of Vrindavan, Bhagwan Sri Krishna. You are the Atma, the soul seated in every heart, Prabhu. And tonight as we listen to the Basuri, your music of love, your music of knowledge, we are about to wave the soft and sacred light before you. May this light shine in the life of Bhaiya Pablo, his wonderful family, his ancestors, and all your wonderful devotees here this evening. May we be guided by this light of your divine grace and mercy, O Krishna. To you this night, salutations again and again. Om Jai Shri Radha, Jai Shri Krishna, Shri Radha Krishnaye Namaha, Shri Radha Krishnaye Namaha. Thank you.
चंदा चंदन चारु तिलक ब्रज चंदा सर्वेला नाल सुनंदा श्री राधा कृष्णाय नमः ओम जय श्री राधा जय श्री कृष्ण श्री राधा कृष्णाय नमः शांति विश्ववेद शांति ब्रह्म शांति सर्वगुण शांति शांति देवा शांति सामा शांति रिधि ओम शांति शांति शांति।
प्रेम से बोलिए वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय। आसन पर बैठाइए प्लीज बी सीटेड। प्रेम से बोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय। इट्स अ ग्रेट प्लेजर माय फ्रेंड्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ सेनियर पाब्लो श्री पाब्लो जी एंड ऑफ कोर्स हिज वंडरफुल कंपेनियन हिज ब्यूटीफुल चिल्ड्रन एंड ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन एंड मेंबर्स ऑफ द एक्सटेंडेड फैमिलीज, we would like to take this opportunity to say a very warm and very special welcome to all the brahmanas, all the pandits who are here this evening, and first and foremost our most senior pandit Shri Pandit Parashuram Ji Maharaj, who have conducted this course last night and puja etc., and I'm sure that we all were touched in a very very special way by his message last night, because what he spoke about indeed, my friends, applies to every aspect of our lives. And again, I want to reiterate that what Panditji spoke about last night, if we practice in our everyday lives, you know, when you look at the Hindu calendar, there is always something religious every single day. And if we were to follow suit, certainly our lives will be even more blessed. We are indeed very blessed, but to become even more blessed. And to you, Baba, we touch your feet tonight and we thank you for your presence, your blessing. And I know this combination of all three pandits here tonight, in the presence of Shri Pandit Navinji and myself, this would have not been possible had it not been for the blessings of Pandit Parashuramji. And to you, Baba, we both, I speak on behalf of Navinji and myself, we both touch your feet and we thank you for allowing us to be at your feet. Even though we are sitting here, we are always at your feet, our senior, and of course, with your blessing, we continue to do what we are doing in the name of Dharma. So to you, Baba, thank you so very much. Also to Pandit Navinji Maharaj, very humble and very simple human being, keeping the light of Sanatana Dharma burning throughout the length and breadth of this beautiful Twin Isle Republic and beyond, to many parts of the world. To you, Panditji, we want to thank you so very much. May God bless you and may He continue to give you the strength, the inspiration, the courage to keep on keeping on, to keep the light of Sanatana Dharma burning in the hearts of so many who loves you and so many who believes in your message, your teaching, and of course your presentation. Tonight also we have our even more senior pandits. Our Shri Pandit Vishal Ji Maharaj, my beloved cousin, the son of the late Pandit Sundar Ji Maharaj, Pandit Pratesh Ji, and he is of course the son of Pandit Parashuram Ji. To you, Baba, thank you so very much, and we bow to you tonight. To Pandit Neil and to Pandit Harish, God bless you, two of our youngest pandits here tonight. May God's blessings be upon you all. And friends, without you, the devotees, we also are nothing in this world. And we want to thank you so very much for coming, as I join with Sharda, the beloved daughter of Bhaiya Padloji, in welcoming each and every one of you. And we thank you for your presence, for every step that you took to reach here is a blessing to this beautiful family and to us all. We also have Pandit Sunil Vasudev Ji. I cannot see him from where I am, but he is here. Baba, special welcome to you as well, and may the blessing of Bhagwan forever be with you and of course your wonderful family. To the members of the Chinmaya Gyan Kirtan Mandali, special thanks for coming and joining with us once again as we glorify our Lord and Divine Master through the medium of the Bhagavad Gita. And Sankit Television capturing tonight's program and doing a very wonderful job in keeping the light of Sanatana Dharma burning throughout the length and breadth of Trinidad and Tobago and beyond. And to you, Bhai Ramesh and Shirley Didi, thank you so very much. To you and your wonderful children, your grandchildren, and of course your loved ones. To all the viewers on Sankit Television, welcome. As we enter your home through the screens of your television, we pray that may the blessing of Bhagwan be with you and of course your loved ones. To the corporate sponsors, we pray for the management and staff of the various companies, in spite of the economic challenging time, for keeping the light of Sanatana Dharma burning through their financial resources. And we have one of our major sponsors here tonight, and that's none other than Bhaiya Prasadji, Mohan Prasad. We say welcome to you, Bhaiyaji, and of course you and your wonderful family. Tonight, my friends, at this time, we want to invite you to sit back and relax as we ask Pandit Parasamji to give his blessings in his own humble way as we commence tonight's devotion together with Pandit Navinji and then myself.
Boliye prem se Sri Krishna Chand Bhagawan ki jai, Umapati Mahadev ki jai. Om Sri Ganeshaya Namaha. Om Sri Mahasaraswate Namaha. Om Sri Guru Charana Kamalebhyo Namaha. Param Dham Parabdhamha Parisham Paramadbhutam Vigna Nigna Karam Shantam Pushtam Kantam Anantakam Sura Surindra Siddhendra Stutam Saumit Parat Param Sur Padma Dineshan Cha Ganeshaya Mangalam Namo Brahmanya Devaya Go Brahmana Hitaya Cha Jagaditaya Krishnaya Govindaya Namo Nama Mangalam Bhagavan Vishnu Mangalam Garudhvaja Mangalam Pundarikaksham Mangalaye Tuno Hari. Bolo Prem Se Sri Krishna Chandra Bhagavan Ki Jai. Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai. Pavan Putra Hanuman Ki Jai. Siyavar Ram Chandra Ki Jai.
Hari Om Krishna Twadiya Pada Pankaj Panjarante Advaiva Me Vishyato Manasarachahamsa Prana prayana samaye kapha bata pitta kanta varo dandita smaranam kutaste vande devo mapatim sudavudum vande jagat karanam Vande Pannaga Bhushanam Mrigadaram Vande Pashunam Patim Vande Surasha Shanga Vahne Nayanam Vande Mukunda Priyam Vande Bhakta Janasrayam Chavardam Vande Shivam Shankaram Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva. Shri Govindaya Namo Namam Parthaya Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Gratitam Purana Munina Madhye Mahabharatam Advaitamrita Varshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatvamanusandadhami Bhagavat Gite भवद्वेषिणी। ओम नमोस्तु ते व्यास विशाल बुद्धे पुल्लार विंदायत पत्र नेत्र येन त्वया भारत तैल पूर्ण प्रज्वालितो ज्ञानमय प्रदीपः प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। सर्वोपनिषदो गावो दुग्धा गोपालनन्दन पार्थो वत्स सुधीर्भोक्ता दुग्धं गीतामृतं महत।
Together everyone,
वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानुरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं। भीष्मद्रोण तथा जयद्रथचला गांधार नीलोत्पला शल्यग्राहवती कृपेन वहनी कर्णेन वेलाकुला। अश्वत्थाम विकर्ण घोरमकरा दुर्योधनावर्तिनी सोतीर्णा खलु पांडवैरननदी कैवर्तक केशवः। पाराशर्यवचः सरोजममलं गीतार्थगन्धोत्कटम् नानाख्यानकेसरं हरिकथा सम्बोधनाबोधितं लोके सज्जन षट्पडैर्हरः पीपीयमानं मुदा भूयात् भारत पंकजं कलिमल प्रध्वं श्रीना श्रेयसे।
मुखं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंगयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंद माधवम्। इट इज बाय योर ग्रेस ओ कृष्णा द डम वैक्सेस एलोक्वेंट द लेम कैन स्केल माउंटेन्स एंड एनी चैलेंजेस दैट कम आवर वे विथ योर ब्लेसिंग वी आर एबल टू ओवरकम। And for this tonight, we thank you, Prabhu. We thank you for being the driver of the chariot of our lives. Sometimes the chariot of our lives may go down in a hole. Sometimes we have to go uphill. Sometimes downhill and around steep corners, O Krishna. But with you as our captain, we are certainly going to reach our destination. May you accept the love of this beautiful family. May you accept the love of all your devotees here tonight. May you bless us and protect us, Prabhu, as we thank you again and again.
Yam Brahma Varunendra Rudra Maruta Stunvanti Divyaistavai वेदैर सांग पद क्रमोपनिषदै गायन्ति यम सामगा ध्यानावस्थित तर्कतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यम योगिनो यस्यांतं न विदुसुरासुरगणा देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः। ओ सर्वधर्मान् परित्यज्य मामेकं शरणं व्रज अहं त्वा सर्वपापेभ्यः मोक्षयिष्यामि मां शुचः। ओम यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः तत्र श्री विजयो भूतिः द्रुवानीति मतिर्मम द्रुवानीति मतिर्मम ॐ सुख दुखे समीकृत्वा ओ कृष्ण We bow to you this night and we pray that in happiness and in sorrow, sukha dukhe samekritva, labha alabha samekritva, jaya or ajaya samekritva, Prabhu, in happiness and in sorrow, gain and in loss, victory and in defeat, as some of the circumstances we experience in this world, as some of the situations that the world presents to us, with your blessing our mind will be guided in the right direction sukha dukhe samikritva labha labhau jaya jayau tato yuddhaya yujjasva Nainam papam avapsyasi Om Namo Narayanaya Namaha Hari Sundar Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari Om Hari Sundar Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari Om Hari Keshava Hari Govinda Hari Narayana Hari Hari Sundar Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari Om Hari Sundar Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari Om Hari Sundar Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari Om
Hari Sundar Nanda Mukunda Hari Narayana Hari Om
Hari Keshava Hari Govinda Hari Narayana Hari Om
सुंदर नंद मुकुंद हरि नारायण हरि ओम।
प्रेम से बोलिए वृंदावन विहारी लाल की जय। Last night, Panaji spoke about the worship of Bhagwan Shri Ganesh and the worship of Ganapati Baba, who is indeed very significant in every form of worship because his name is chanted at the beginning of every puja, every yagya, every satsang, any form of devotion we pray to Bhagwan Ganesh. Firstly, I welcome my beloved father, Shri Pandit Devaki Prasad Sharmaji, and thank him for being here tonight with us. So last night, Panditji, he mentioned that in the Ganesh Puran, in the beginning, even before Parvati Devi and Bhagwan Shiva came together as Pati and Patni, the worship of Bhagwan Ganesh was done. Because a ceremony was about to take place. And if the ceremony is about to take place, then puja must be done. And if puja must be done, then the worship of Bhagwan Ganesh must be conducted. So even then, Ganesh Baba was existing. Even before Shiva, Bhagwan Shiva and Parvati Devi came together in, you know, marriage. My dear brothers and sisters. And it shows from the altar of Hinduism that there are God in the unmanifest form, and there are also manifestations of God in the manifest form. So you have the unmanifest and the manifest. And even before the various avatar comes into existence, what you have is Bhagwan existing in the unmanifest state, in the unmanifest form. So when we meditate upon Bhagwan, we can either meditate upon him in the manifest. You have Nirguna Brahman and Saguna Brahman. So we can meditate upon Bhagwan in what you call the manifest state or the unmanifest state. It all depends on the level of self-unfoldment, the level of spirituality that we have developed, or the level of which we are able to control our mind. My friends, sometimes, for example, if a person is a what you call a professional swimmer, that person can go into any pool, any depth, maybe the ocean, and can swim as far as he or she wants. They don't need a life jacket, and they don't need any form of protection to keep them afloat because they are professional swimmers, trained swimmers. They are lifesavers, in other words. So the swimmer who is an expert in this can go to any ocean, any depth, any time and swim for as long as he or she might be able to do it. Send me in the same water and I will be able to reach 10 feet. And then I'll call, Bachao, please help. And now the same lifeguard or the person who is trained will have to come and save me because I am not a professional swimmer. My friends, how come the person who is the professional swimmer can go deep for a long period of time and the person who is not a professional swimmer can't go deep for a long period of time? How come? Oh, you know, the water loves that guy more than me. Or the water is biased towards that person and that water is very racial towards me. So maybe I try to find fault with the water. But you see, friends, the water is not at fault. It is I who have not developed my swimming skills in order to swim out far into the ocean for a long period of time. And as a result of that, because I did not develop myself, the water is not at fault, and nor the professional swimmer is at fault. It is I am the one to be blamed for my inefficiency. In the same way, my friends, for the person who is spiritually developed, don't need a form of God to meditate on. For a person who is spiritually developed, they don't need what you call any particular manifestation to meditate on. They will meditate upon the unmanifest anywhere they are at any point in time for a long period of time, because they have trained themselves in a very spiritual way and developed their spirituality. So they don't need any particular form like you and I might need. So the person who have not developed themselves, that person now has to, what you call, go through the process of training him, his or herself. And in that way, with time and with constant practice, we will be able to develop control over the mind, which is called in Vedanta as Mano Nigraha. Mano Nigraha meaning control of the mind. And when we are able to do that, the result will be that we are then in control of not only the mind, we are in control of our emotions. And that comes from spirituality. That comes from the practice of meditation that Panditji spoke about last night, where Bhagwan Shiva and Parvati were coming together. Shiv and Shakti, Ardhanareshwar, coming together. But yet, their son, who was not even born yet, was worshipped and was praised even before the marriage of his mother and father. So, from the altar of Sanatana Dharma, my friends, it is said that we can think of God anytime, wherever we are, at any pointing moment, where we can see him in an unmanifest state. And this is why Panaji made it very clear last night that there are different kalpas and there are different age in which the scriptures are read and narrated by different saints and sages. And the episode he gave last night was, he said, was the very first manifestation of Bhagwan Ganesh. And the one that we are accustomed to, Adolji, the one that we are accustomed to is when he sent the Trishul and took off the head of the little boy, and Mother Parvati took the dirt and she made him out of that. That's the one we are accustomed to. But there are so many different avatars of Bhagwan Sri Ganesh for that self-development and spiritual development. But Baba, why are you going back to last night? And you are supposed to be doing Gita tonight. Because, my friends, with the blessing of Ganesh Baba, we can be guided on the path of wisdom. And on the path of wisdom, Bhagwan Krishna tells us that the manner in which we have to develop ourselves. Sangeeta ji, how do you develop yourself? Eat plenty food? Exercise regularly? Join the gym? And from 10 pounds, you start developing bicep and tricep and no concept. And then we work out the legs and we work out the upper back and we work out the shoulders. And in the gym, we develop our bodies. We develop different parts of our bodies. That's why, again, the trainer will teach in the gym bicep, tricep, work out legs today, do lower back, do upper back. And they will take it in phases. Friends, can I ask you all a question? How do we develop ourselves spiritually? How do we develop ourselves spiritually? Is it just that we do puja, we get up early in the morning and we offer lota gel, we do our job? Yes, all those are wonderful practice of our culture and our dharma. But Bhagwan Krishna takes us to a different level. In the 16th chapter of the Gita, he begins in a very inspirational and a very beautiful way when he says,
Shri Govindaya Namo Namam Parama Atmaya Krishnaya Govindaya Namo Namaha Paramatmaya Ramaya Govindaya Namo Namaha Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha Ata Shodha Shodhyaya Shri Bhagavanu Vacha Abhayam Sattva Samshuddhi Jnana Yoga Vyavasthitihi Danam Damascha Yagyascha Swadhyaya Stapa Archavam
अहिंसा सत्यम क्रोध त्याग शांतिरपैशुनम दया भूतेश्व लोलुप्त्वं मार्दवं ह्रीर चापलं श्री गोविंदाय नमः परमात्माय कृष्णा गोविंदाय नमो नमः गोविंदाय नमो नमः
एवरी वन ऑफ अस हैज टू डेवलप आवरसेल्व्स Not in a physical way, but with talking now, diverting now from the body, we know how to develop the body. Eat right, exercise regularly, join the gym, eat the right type of food, eat at the right time. That is for the body. No doubt, we all will maintain that routine and we all will try our best to burn as much calories to maintain the best health each day of our lives, and that is for the body. My friends, we have to also now, from the body, we have to go to the mind. The mind is the seat of emotions. That is what the mind is. The mind is the seat of emotion. The body is the seat of action. So you have all the karma indriyas, all the actionable indriyas or equipment in the body, the hands, the organ of speech, the legs, etc. So we have the five organs of action. Now, these are governed by the mind. And the mind is very interesting to understand because what the mind is made up of, ask yourself, what the body is made up of? The body is made up of blood, bone, flesh, tissues, etc. What is the mind made up of? What's the mind made up of, Bhaiyaji? Anybody? Very good. Bhaiyaji said a bundle of thoughts. The mind is made up of a bundle of thoughts, but it is explained as it is made up of a high frequency of thoughts. So thoughts are gushing through the mind constantly, and every thought creates an emotion. So now we are overwhelmed by emotions, we are overwhelmed by thoughts, we are overwhelmed by whatever is happening at the level of the mind, and that also dictates the pace that you and I are conducting on the outside. So we must be very aware, and I want you to remember this word tonight, aware, be aware of whatever is coming through your mind. Like you at home, you be aware of who comes to your home. In America and Canada and those parts of the world, Baba, when people go into sleep in the night, Hun, I love you. I love you, baby. And they go to sleep. In Trinidad, when you're going to sleep, you lock the front door, you lock the back door, you lock the gate, you check outside. So people in other parts of the world, they will be saying, I love you, and they will go to sleep. We have to be careful. We have to be careful who we allow to enter our premises. We have to be careful who we allow to enter into our lives. And in the same way, be aware of whatever is entering your mind. Spirituality has a lot, my friends, to do with the mind, because we become overwhelmed by the emotions of the mind. And one of the emotions of the mind, Bhagwan Krishna says, bhaya. Bhaya means fear. But we must not have fear. He says, abhayam. Sattva samshuddhihi jnana yoga vivastitihi. He says we must develop ourselves in such a way that we do not become the victim of fear. Be fearless, because our real potential and our real what you call ability comes from a fearless mind. Our real potential is developed from a fearless mind. Don't be scared, don't be fearless. Rather, don't be frightened, but be fearless in whatever you are doing. Once it is on the path of dharma, once it is on the path of what is right, have no fear. If it is something wrong, yeah, be frightened. Because either the law is going to catch up with you or somebody is going to catch up. Because where there is a dharma, naturally there will be fear. If you are doing what is right, then there is no need to have any fear. One of the greatest fear people have is what? One of the greatest fear we have is the fear of death. Isn't it? The fear of death, some people scared for that moment. If death comes now, anybody ready? I will be the first to be under the singhasan. Not ready. But the thing about death will come anytime. So we have to be ready. So the greatest fear that we have is the fear of death. It is called in Vedanta as removing this fear, avinivesh, the fear of death. And my friends, Bhagwan says, if we really want to develop ourselves spiritually, the first thing we have to do is remove all fear from the mind. Wherever you go, he says, put me first. And I want you, my friends, to understand the meaning of putting God first. It's not just about, okay, Lord, you know, I believe in you and I chant your name, etc. I believe in my heart that you will make impossibilities become possible. I believe in my heart that you will make poison nectar. I believe the situation I'm having at my job, you will convert it from negative to positive. I believe that the people who don't like me, you will bless me to still work with them and be able to overcome and be successful. My friends, there are people who are going through situations in their life right now. Some may be at home, some may be at work, some maybe they just do not know in which direction to turn. And in every direction they turn, there is darkness. Remember this bhajan that says, Jab charo taraf andhiyara ho, aasha ka dur ki nara ho. You remember, my friends, I don't know if you have this experience, but sometimes in some people's life, every direction, jaba charu tarafa andhiyara ho, every direction they turn, there is darkness. And not only that, all hope gone. Aasha ka dur kinara ho. Even the hope goes away. I don't know if anyone would have been in that situation or is in that situation, or maybe get into a situation like that. I pray with that Bhagwan will never send us into such a situation where there is darkness on all sides. But his very presence will be light. The light of peace and happiness and hope. So, jab charu taraf andhiyara ho, but never forget.
Tum karuna ke sagar, tum palan karta. Swami, tum palan karta. Main murak kal kami, main sevak kripa karo.
Never forget, my friends. Tum karuna ke sagar. He is the ocean of compassion. And he is the ocean of mercy and grace. Therefore, if he is that, and we believe in him, and we understand that he is the one who is driving the chariot of our lives, and we believe that he is the captain of our lives, why not, my friends, have that faith in his karuna and remove any fear from our minds? But Pablo G, once in his life, hit rock bottom. Went right down to zero. And recently we were talking on the phone and he said, Baba, I had nothing except my God. I had nothing, I from everything went down to zero, zilch, nada. But I had my God with me. And easy by easy, it came back up. And you know, my friends, that is what we are talking about. You see, that fearlessness, once you know that you have your Bhagwan with you, there is nothing in this world that can take us down and keep us down. It may be able to take us down, but they can't keep us down. whether it's a person, whether it's a situation. Once we develop abhaya, and that is a mental thing. That is something that happens at the level of the mind. You see, I could be praying, you know, I could take out my mala and chant, Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama, Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And while I'm chanting the mala, it is only the mouth moving. The mind is thinking about the trouble and the worries and the problem. The mind is connected, the mind is overwhelmed by the situation. And I'm not saying that we are weak. What I'm saying is we have to be aware of where the mind is in order to receive that positive energy from the universe that Bhagwan is. Bhagwan is everywhere, my friends. Look at that picture at the back of Avinash and there. You will see the Dasha Avatar. Sorry, at the back of Sham. Dasha Avatar, you will see the 10 manifestations of Bhagwan Vishnu. He is here, dear, and everywhere. He is the universe. And friends, and as Hindus, and for those who are non-Hindus tonight and are here, or might be looking at Sankhya, Bhagwan, God, the way you call him, he is here, dear, and everywhere. And what we cannot do, my friends, is allow ourselves to have fear and give up in this world. That's why he is telling Arjuna here on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, hey Arjuna, one of the first quality you must develop is abhayam. In order to win this war, in order to win this battle, you must be fearless. In order to win the war, you know, in order to win the battle, we have to be fearless. Imagine you're going into war. You're going into a situation where you are overwhelmed with bhaya, with fear. But Bhagwan is Krishna saying, he says, abhaya, remove the fear from your mind. And the reason why he's telling Arjuna this, because my friends, where there is fear, there is weakness. I repeat, where there is fear, there is weakness. And where there is fearlessness, there is strength. I tell you my poor stance. Where there is fearlessness, there is strength, my dear brothers and sisters. And therefore he says to Arjuna, when you develop this attitude and you develop your mind in this way, it is like you are at the gym. But you are not working out your legs today. You are not working out your bicep or your tricep or your stomach. You are not looking for the six pack. What you are working out today is your mind. Today, in the gym of spirituality, we are working out the mind, and we are now being aware of what the mind is working on, or the mind is worried about, or the mind is contemplating upon. Am I working out my mind with negative energy, or am I working out my mind with positive energy? Am I connecting to this universe that has both energies, positive and negative? Which one I am connecting to? And you see, friends, whatever we connect the mind to, whatever we connect the mind to, that is where we will get our strength from. Or we either become weak if we are connected to negative energy. We can't get rid of the negative energy. It's part of the universe. You cannot take off the negative pole on the battery of the car. We need it. It needs to be grounded. But we have to be aware of what is happening at the level of the mind. And this is why, my friends, we live in a world where we can become very overwhelmed. And this is why bhajans like these tells us,
Banavari re jin ka sahara tera naam re mujhe duniya walon se kya kaam re.
There is nothing in this world, my friends, O Krishna, that your name cannot help us across.
Banwari re jin ka sahara tera naam re mujhe duniya walon se kya kaam re.
Thank you. Samshuddhi, meaning that the mind will then develop the tendency to become pure. Sattva Samshuddhi. And friends, purity of mind means what? And this is especially for the youngsters and the youths and our children. You know, we try to protect our children with our life. And all of us as parents will want to do that. And I want all the young people tonight to be very attentive. Purity of mind means what? We are not talking about cleanliness of the mind. We are talking about purity of the mind. You see, I can clean my body and I can make my body pure. Right? I can clean my body. How? Soap and water. Duh. Clean your body with soap and water. What kind of soap? Blue soap. Didi said blue soap. That's after Pagwa, we use blue soap. The blue soap is take out all the abir. So we clean the body with soap and water. There is nothing magical about that. Basic soap, basic water, clean yourself. How to make the body pure? If you clean it, you have to make it pure. How? Sattva Samshuddhi. To make the body pure, we need Indriya Nigraha. Indriya Nigraha meaning that we must control the eyes, the ears, the nose, the tongue, and the skin. We must control the hands, the legs, the mouth. Oh God, control the mouth. Control the procreation and the excretion organ, which, my friends, are the five Gyan Indriyas and the five Karma Indriyas of the body. So once we are able to develop control, I am not supposed to see this, I don't want to see it. I'm not supposed to hear this, I don't want to hear it. I'm not supposed to smell this, I don't want to smell it. I'm not supposed to eat this, I don't want to taste it. I'm not supposed to touch this, I don't want to do it. I'm not supposed to go to this place, I am not going. So controlling of the 10 organs of the body is called as Indriya Nigraha. And that, my friends, is what we call in our language, fasting. So fasting the eyes, fasting the ears, fasting the nose, fasting the tongue. What we believe is fasting is, Baba, I'm fasting for 21 days now, you know. 21 days, Baba, I'm fasting. Nothing, you know. Yeah, eaten. But what do you mind thinking? What the hands doing? What the mouth saying? Baba fasting, you know. But you're insulting everybody? And you're fasting? You know, I don't know if you all had this experience before, but sometimes when you're fasting, you'll get angry fast. You know, kind of lose patience. Like when Narottam time and come and all the Baba, everybody fasting. We could lose patience very quickly because what we are doing in the body is it also takes a toll on the mind. So we can lose that. Control the mind. Sorry, control the organ of speech. And when we control these organs, that is real fasting. So let us take fasting to a different level. Not just about the food, but fasting the mouth and what you say and how you say it. Fast the eyes, fast the ears, fast the nostrils, the hands, the legs, the procreation, the excretion, all the organs of the body. And in this way, when we fast and we have it under control, then, my friends, notice something, and I want you to practice this. Decide tomorrow, anytime, for 15 minutes. I'm going to control my eyes, my ears, my nose. I don't want to listen to anything. I don't want to see anything. I don't want to touch anything. I don't want to see anything. I don't want to do nothing. I'm just going to observe silence, silence, silence. And when you are sitting in that silence, automatically the mind slips into meditation. Because silence is meditation. That is called as Indriya Nigraha. Controlling of the senses and controlling of the, in fact, purifying the mind, purifying the body. Special welcome to Atmaji Panditji. My friends, so Sattva Samshuddhi means that we purify the body also. So you clean it and you purify it. So we know about cleaning the body, and now we know about fasting and purifying the body. How to clean the mind? Which brand of soap? Not blue soap, you know. Dove. Jai Bhagwan. You see, to clean the mind, you don't need soap and water. Kabir Dashi says in a very wonderful dohe, he says,
Nindakiniye re rakiye angan kuti chava sabun bina pani bina nirmal kare kavai.
Sabun bina pani bina nirmal kare kavai. Clean yourself without soap and water. How are you doing that? Sabun bina, pani bina. Sabun is soap. Pani is water. So sabun bina, without soap and water, clean yourself. Oh, Baba, we understand what you're saying. No soap and water? Jai Bhagwan, take a few drops and Jai Ganga Jala. Quick shower. You see, Kabir Dashi is taking, my friends, us from away the physical. He is taking us now to the mental. Sabun bina, pani bina nirmal kare kavai. But what you have to do that? He says, nindaki nere rakiye angana kuti chavai. Build a hut in front of your home and put the person who don't like you and who gossip about you and who bad talk you to live in front of your house. And every morning, that the first person you see, and every evening, that's the last person you see, and you know that person don't like you, put them to live in front of your house. My friends, see how long you will hate that person for. 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, after that you stop hating. You can't hate somebody all the time. You can't be angry with somebody all the time. You can't be negative towards someone all the time, my friends. When we are able to overcome such, what you call, situation at the mental level, the mind becomes clean. My dear brothers and sisters, the mind is made up of a high frequency of thoughts. Sattva Samshuddhi, meaning that when the thousands of thoughts passes through the mind every day, when you go to the river to bathe, when you go to the ocean to bathe, when you go to a place to bathe, if the water is dirty, you don't go in. Sometimes, again, we live in Trinidad and our water supply is supplied by the Vasa. So So sometimes when you open the tap, you see nice clear water coming. You could put your cup and drink it. And then sometimes you open your tap and you see brown water coming. What do? Put your cup. Friends, when you look at your mind and you see clean thoughts, dance with joy. And when you look at your mind and you see brown thoughts, run away with joy from those thoughts. We have to be aware. This is spirituality in action. This is self-development and spiritual awareness, friends, when we are aware at this level. And therefore, Bhagwan says here, Sat abhayam sattva samshuddhihi jnana yoga vyavastitihi. Establish yourself in this jnana yoga. Baba talked about the rituals last night in a very beautiful way when he spoke about, you know, how to prepare yourself for children and the different names of Bhagwan Ganesh you chant every month. Baba, that was very inspiring to me also. It was a reminder, and it was so divine to be reminded of this wonderful method of worshipping Bhagwan Ganesh in this way. Now, you see, the rituals is one thing. But Jnana Yoga is a different thing. Again, we have risen from the level of the body to the mind, and then Jnana Yoga. We establish the mind in what is called Jnana Yoga. We know about Karma Yoga, we know about Bhakti Yoga, we know about, what kind of yoga again? Jnana Yoga, the Bhagavad Gita is divided in three parts. Karma Yoga, first six chapters. Second six chapters, you have Bhakti Yoga, and the third six chapters, you have Jnana Yoga. So Jnana Yoga Vyavastitihi, establish yourself in this Jnana Yoga. How? Okay, what is the meaning of yoga? You see, everybody can see this? Maya Amarji, can you see what I just did? So Maya Amarji got very worried. This is a microphone cord, and this is a microphone. This microphone, if I speak in it, you'll be able to hear me properly. But if I speak, can you hear me? This microphone is not connected. When the microphone cord is in yoga with the microphone, you are going to get oh God. Wait, Amarji? What is switch? When the microphone cord is in yoga with the microphone, you are going to get sound. Once there is no yoga, it is there, but it may have no value. Once there is yoga, it has value. Friends, in the same way, when the mind is in yoga with the higher energy and the higher power of Jnana, then it becomes of value, of significance. But if the mind is not connected to that Jnana Yoga, to that Jnana, then what happens is we are just functioning in the world based on our sanskar, and therefore we are acting like a program robot. When you program a robot, you tell your robot what to do. So if we are programmed and we are governed by karma, my friends, then we are just living every day exhausting karma. We have to rise beyond that and be in charge of our lives and be in charge of our being and be in charge of ourselves. And how to do that, my friends, is that we have to burn up the karma through the meditation, through the connection of yoga, and by Naam Smaran, chanting the Lord's name. In this way, having that faith and that belief in Bhagwan, and what happens then? through this Jnana Yoga, the mind becomes absolutely pure and purified. The intellect becomes sanctified. And in this way, my friends, we become fearless in this world. And there is nothing that such a person cannot achieve in this world. There is nothing such an individual cannot attain, my dear brothers and sisters. And so, Bhagwan Krishna says in the Gita to Arjuna, Abhayam Sattva Samshuddhi Jnana Yoga Vyavastitihi. You need to establish yourself in this yoga. And you know what Bhagwan Sri Ram and Tulsidashi says in the Ramcharitamanas? Very beautiful chopa, he says.
Shri
Sumati Kumati Sabha Ke Ura Rahahi. They, Sumati and Kumati lives in the same place. You know the bhajan that says, Sukha Dukha Dono Rahate Jisame Jivan Hevo Gao. Both of them, happiness and sorrow, live in the same place. Sumati and Kumati living in the same place. Na Tapurana Nigama Asakahi. So what is Sumati? Su means beautiful and Mati means intelligence. A person who is connected to that supreme divine energy and a person who is connected to their pure self, their atma, their soul, and who is aware of the contents of their mind and disassociate themselves from the negatives of the mind, that person can be called Sumati. And the one who is always connected to negativity and who is always complaining and sees nothing good in anybody in this world, that person is associated with Kumati. You know, one person was telling recently, say, Baba, anything I do at my job is never good for the supervisor. I am supposed to work from 7 to 4:30. And I would work from 7 to 10:30 in the night. And that is not good for the supervisor. And always putting pressure, always complaining, and always doing all negative things to me. And I said to her, she's one of my goddaughter, I said, you know, whatever you go through at work, you may not be able to change your job right now, or you may not have a vacancy, or what you call, there might be a vacancy anywhere else for you to leave to go. But whatever you go through and whatever your supervisor is doing to you, allow it to make you a stronger person. Because my friends, when people put pressure on us out of their negative, if we treat it with the Sumati attitude, with the right attitude, that makes us stronger individuals to face any situation down the road in the future. So don't allow pressure now given to you by someone who may be jealous of you, or somebody who just negative, or someone who just, you know, can't see goodness. Take the pressure. Stand up for your rights if you can and when you want. Don't be abused, or don't allow people to abuse you. Stand up if you have to. But at the same time, if your job depends on it, if a situation depends on it, and you have to, and you have no better way out, then allow it to make you a stronger person. Sumati. That is what gives us strength. And Kumati is that which takes us down. How can Sumati be born in our lives? Sumati can be born in our lives through Sattva Sam Shuddhi Jnana Yoga. When we establish ourselves in this yoga, then Sumati becomes part of our lives. Meaning that we now have a beautiful Mati. Mati meaning the intellect. If the mind, if the intellect becomes crooked, then that is Kumati. Pabloji, you know in the Ramayana, who was Kumati? Did he? Well, it'll have nobody named Kumati in our mind. who is Kumati in our mind? Anybody who acted with a crooked intellect is Kumati in our mind. So number one, Ravan. Number two, Kumbhakarna. Number three, Mantra. Mantra was one of the queen of crookedness. She was the queen of crookedness. I know what this crookedness. You see, friends, God forbid. A person may have a crooked body based on some health issue. That, I pray, if anyone is experiencing any health issue, may Bhagwan bless you to be healed and to be able to overcome that. But you see, friends, if your body is bent for some reason or the other, nothing wrong with that. But you see, when the mind is bent, Baba, what do? The same thing Baba and I do in every night. Talking to help us, not only you, to help us, we ourselves, to straighten our minds. Friends, it is better to have a crooked body and a straight mind than a crooked mind and a straight body. Om Namah Shivaya. You know how many people body straight and mind crooked? Oh yeah, Baba, I know. I know a few fellas right down the road there. Baba, they look so straight and tall, eh? But their mind real crooked. Friends, don't point fingers at nobody. I want you and I to take out the mirror and look at ourselves to see if we are crooked internally. That's why. It's like a bow, you know? The bow that Bhagwan Sri Ram had, the Dhanush Bhan. When that bow was placed there, it was called Shiva Dhanush. And the only person who could have strung that bow and broke it was the person who was qualified to shoot that bow, to shoot the arrow out of that bow to its target. The only person who is able, my friends, to straighten the mind is one who is able to practice Chitta Ekagrata. Chitta Ekagrata means single pointedness of the mind. Chitta Ekagrata is the arrow on the bow of the mind. And the mind can be crooked. The bow can be crooked. The bow can be bent. But the arrow can't be bent. If the arrow is bent, you're going to miss your target. If the arrow is not straight, we are going to miss that target, my friends. That's why when Bhagwan Sri Ram when he went to lift the bow, first thing he did was he touched the bow and he meditated upon Bhagwan Shiva and
Mera bola hai bandari kare nande ke savari bole nath re Shankar nath re Mera bola hai bandari kare nande ke savari bole nath re Shankar nath re Mera bola hai bandari kare nande ke savari bole nath re Shankar nath re Tera naam hai purhara ek tu hai hai palanhara bole nath re Shankar साथ रे ओ भगवान शिव श्री राम सिंह मेरे साथ रे मे यू बी विथ मी माय लॉर्ड ओ भगवान आई एम गोइंग टू लिफ्ट योर धनुष बट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंटली द एरो दैट आई प्लेस ऑन दिस मस्ट बी स्ट्रेट माय फ्रेंड्स श्री राम लिफ्ट द धनुष बाण टू मैरी सीता देवी एंड दैट स्वयंवर एंड वी थिंक दैट ऑल द पीपल हु वर देयर कुड नॉट लिफ्ट द बो Ravan was a mighty king, but he could not lift the bow. All the kings of all the different places came and could not lift the bow. You know why? Because every one of them, my friends, their arrow was not straight. The arrow was not straight, my dear brothers and sisters. To have a straight body and a crooked mind means that we are going to miss the target in life, the goal, the destiny. Our soul, our atma.
Mera bola hai bandari kare nandi ke sawari bole nath re Shankar nath re Mera bola hai bandari kare nandi ke sawari Shankar nath re Tera naam hai karan hara ek tu hai palan hara bole
shuddhi. Purify this mind, connecting to Bhagwan Shiva. And friends, once the arrow is straight, we are going to get the strength to do anything in this world. That is why all the other people who were there could not lift the bow of Bhagwan Shiva. None of them could lift it. It was not that they were weak, but their mind was not straight. Friends, when the mind is straight, that is where our strength is, and we can achieve anything in this life. I will finish this bhajan next time. Very important, when the mind is straight and the arrow is straight on the bow of the mind, you know what happens then? Danam damascha yagyascha swadhyayastapa arjavam. Bhagwan says, these words are very powerful. Dan means charity. Dan means giving something to someone out of compassion. Dan means where you put yourself in other people's situation and you do something to help them. That's dan. It doesn't necessarily mean giving money or things like that. It means anything you do with the attitude of love, that is dan. So dan, every day, if you can give someone something, is a great blessing in life. And not plenty, you know. A little bit. Little thing. It doesn't have to be much. If your paycheck is $5 a day and you give 5 cents from that, you gave. That's dan. But don't look for anything in return. So danam damascha yagyascha. Dana meaning give charity. And this is not putting butter and bread or praising Pablo G for what he does in terms of his charity, etc. But he is a dani. He is a giver. I don't want you to get any... you know the old people have a saying, they said, don't get swell-headed, boy. Don't get swell-headed. Remember, my friends, we could only give when we have. And dan means one of the greatest things that we can give is food. And what is even greater than food is gyan. Give gyan itself. Give knowledge. So whatever you give, that comes from that which is purifying. And therefore, Bhagwan says to Arjuna here, he says, danam damascha yagyascha swadhyayastapa arjavam. And as I prepare myself to conclude tonight, he says, damascha, we spoke about this earlier. You have Shama, Dama, Uparama, Titiksha, and all these are Vedantic terms that means something for our spiritual development, our self-unfoldment, and this is what spirituality is about. So, Dana meaning giving charity, Damascha, Damascha meaning controlling of the senses that we spoke about earlier, Yagya, Yagya means, what is a Yagya? What is a yagya? 3 days, 7 days, 5 days, 7 days, Bhagwat, 7 days, Shiv Puran, 7 days, Devi Yagya, 7 days, Ramayana. Is that yagya? In the, when two people are getting married, you know, one of the vows that the dulahin is asking the dulaha is that if ever you have to do a yagna, I want to be with you. And if you all remember in the Ramayana, when Sri Ram had to perform the Ashwamedh Yagya, he could not perform the Yagya if Sita Devi was not there. And he was advised by his guru, make the golden murti of Sita and put her to sit down next to you, and then the Yagya will you can start the Yagya. So the Dulahin must be there for that Yagya to be successful once you are married. As a Karmakanda aspect of the Vedas. Dulahin must be there. So yagya in that particular vow means if ever you are performing a yagya, she says, I want to be with you to perform that yagya so that we can get the full benefit and the merit of that yagya. In that case, my friends, in the vow, it is not only talking about the 7 days yagya, but it is talking about to the husband. She is saying to him, if ever you have to make a personal sacrifice, I want to be there with you. And which husband doesn't make personal sacrifices? Which husband? Which father? Which brother doesn't make personal sacrifice? Which son doesn't? And Dulahin? Which Dulahin doesn't make personal sacrifices? So everyday life is a yagya. Danam namascha yagyascha. Whatever you sacrifice to do becomes a yagya in your life. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, when we do this yagya, danam namascha yagyascha, then swadhyaya stapa arjavam. Swadhyaya mean, swa mean you yourself. Like right now, Baba is saying swaha. Swaha, and he's offering in the fire. And swa adhyaya, swa meaning me, myself. Adhyaya means study about me. Adhyaya means a study. So study about myself. And when I study about myself, my dear brothers and sisters, meaning the soul, the atma, when I study about who I am, when I study my mind, when I study about my the emotions of my mind, when I become aware of it, then in that way, danam damashyaya swadhyaya tapa arjavam, performing tapasya, etc., then life becomes spiritual and not religious. It is better to live a spiritual life than a religious life. And spiritual life means everywhere you go, be aware of what is happening inside of you. Be alert and vigilant. Let your life, let our lives become a meditation. This is what Bhagwan Krishna is giving to Arjuna on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. And this is why, my friends, Arjuna getting this knowledge, hearing this knowledge, he is saying,
Vo kala ek basuri wala, Vo kala ek basuri wala, Sud bisra gaya mori re, Sud bisra gaya mori, Vo kala ek basuri wala.
Amen.
बोलिए वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की। एंड सो माय फ्रेंड्स, एज आई कंक्लूड टुनाइट, वी प्रे दैट मे भगवान ब्लेस अस दैट वी डेवलप आवरसेल्व्स थ्रू द रिचुअल्स, थ्रू द पूजा, थ्रू द फास्टिंग, थ्रू द डिवोशन, बट मेंटली वी मस्ट ऑल्सो बी एबल टू फ्लेक्स आवर सिक्स पैक। डू यू फ्लेक्स द सिक्स पैक? You can't flex six pack, eh? We could show it. When we flex our bicep and our tricep, from the gym of spirituality, we are able then to flex ourselves mentally, intellectually, spiritually. We are connected to this Jnana Yoga, this Yoga of the Self. And my friends, most importantly, just like we feel proud when our body is healthy and strong and looking good, in the same way, we'll feel peace and happiness when we are connected to the right energy and the right supply of divinity within ourselves. In that way, we don't depend on anyone, we don't depend on anything for peace, for happiness, for liberation. Bhaiya Pablo ji, may Bhagwan bless you and your wonderful companion, your children, your grandchildren, your beloved mom and dad here this evening. And may Bhagwan bless the generation from which you came, and a very wonderful individual he is, Bhaiya Pablo ji, that is, and his wonderful family. And when he first called and he asked for this yagya, he said, Baba, I want you, I want my Guruji, Pandit Parasram, and I want Pandit Navin. I said, that's okay, we all will come. But I never expected all this three seat here, Baba. But somehow I felt, if it was up to Pablo, he would have put 5 Singhasan here and invite all the pandits he loved to bring them and put them here. And it shows the type of individual he is. And to you, Bhaiya ji, God bless you and your wonderful family now and forever. We will chant the mantra for the Purnahuti and offer in the fire, and then we have blessings coming again from our pandits and our loved ones. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Sarvam Vai Purnagvam Swaha Om Sarva Papaharam Divyam Gangeyam Nirmalam Jalam आचमन्यं मया दत्तं गृहान् परमेश्वरम् ॐ वनस्पतिर्सो भूतो गन्धाद्यो गन्धरुत्तम आग्र्य सर्वदेवानां धूपोऽयं प्रतिग्रताम् ॐ श्रीधूपम् आग्रापयामि। एवरीवन लिफ्ट योर हैंड्स एंड रिसीव द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ द यज्ञ। I should have asked you all to stand and we may get the offering. Nevertheless, Jai Bhagwan. At this point in time, I hand over to you. I will hand over to the host himself, Bhaiyaji, to give greetings on behalf of himself and his family.
Sitaram, everybody. Hari. Today is a great day for myself, to be honest. And first, I will start with a little mantra. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Shri Ganeshaya Namah. Om Siddhi Saraswati Mataye Namah. First, I must pay respect to the Vyas Pandit Parasram Maharaj. He is my guru. I have known him for over 30 years. And when I met him in a yag in Pinal. And he was doing Krishna Bhagwan Puja, reading the Bhagavatam. So when I heard him, I said, you know, who is this? You know, he was so clean with what he was doing that you could have seen the message coming. And I got that message from him and asked him, he said, night, I said, Babs. Because when I met him, as Pandit Abhidanan knew my story, I was bottomless, not a dollar in my pocket. I met Pandit Parasram, and he is a judge for where Pablo is today. That's the fact. Baba, I want to pay that respect to you, and nothing that I do, that I do not discuss it with you before I make any action. I met Pandit Narvin same time after a while, but I met Pandit Abhidanan in Pattiram trees, and I saw Pandit Abhidanan so humble, so simple, so real kind, loving person. I personally has a special love for Pandit Abhidanan. Like, you know, somebody would like a girl. I'm not saying that, that way, Babs. But I like you, I believe, more than way you like yourself. I have a problem with that, you know, I am confessing. If I don't confess, I'll be a liar. He's like, you know, so close to my heart that I just have a like this for him. And then Pandit Narvin, I met him in St. Cross. And there is where we connected, because I sponsored the program, I think. Yes, I did that. It's Lodians, Lodian Temple. So all the three masters of the scriptures, I met them in special places. And Pandit Abhidanan, I was giving him this story when I met him in Pattiram trees. That temple is a temple that you should visit. I'm not advertising any temple, so don't get me wrong. But when I went to the temple, there is a distance from the temple gate to the Murti, the Lingam. And I had lost everything. But I then lost my way with my mother, blessing, and knowledge that she shared with me on a daily basis. My father was a workhouse, so we never had that interaction like my mother. Ma, Sitaram, thanks for the knowledge you have given me. The gift she had given to me is not, you cannot measure it, because it's something special, spiritual. She spent all her time with me saying, brother boy, that's my nickname, brother boy. Sometimes when the pandits singing the chowpai, which I love to hear, I was telling Pandit Abhidanan and Narvin and Imbaba, where it's from, I love to hear the scriptures, I like to hear the singing, I like to hear the chowpais in particular, that, you know, I follow the pandits, that what I, and I follow everybody, to be honest, but I follow the message that they give that must be from the book and nothing from the book. Because I had met an old sadhu who is 90 something years old, he had passed away, and his son-in-law is a pandit, and he said, Pablo, I would not listen to him. He don't need to know what Lavantel do or where. He would read that in the papers. So we stick to the scriptures, and that's where we get the essence of the scriptures. And I am so happy and pleased to have three real top of the line men. I'm not saying that nobody is not top of the line, but please forgive me if I say something wrong or if anybody feel any how. But I had handpicked these guys, these three pandits, that they are very, very close and dear to me. And Pandit Narvin is responsible for a lot of things I do lately. And I was, you know, if we do some feeding in Manzilla Beach, and I was telling Narvin, when I feed the 650 children in Shiva Boys, I told him for 3 days, I was in joy, like if I just win the lotto, 100 million US. I couldn't come off that 3 days of that 650 children we had feed. But with Baba intervention, and his permission, Baba, I will take the opportunity with your blessing that I would like to move forward again with my next program, which I have in mind from a long time. And having three pandits today was one of my wish from a little boy. I had this wish that I always wanted this. And I have to thank God for making it happen. God, you are great. Because without you, I am nothing. and Bhagwan Shri Krishna, he knows best. I will just sing a chant that the experience I have. I would like to sing a little chant for my little daughter who I had lost, and the other family members who are the older ones who have passed away in the family and other families. And I say prayer for other families who somewhere not resting in peace, that we can put them to rest in peace. So I will sing a little bhajan and ask Lord Krishna to shower his blessing on them. And I ask Lord Krishna, I'll beg him, from the trip and the time here, having here today, if I have this team, I know I can go far with my motive in the spiritual world, with the guru blessing from the Parashram, we can go far. Baba, so I put you on our spot again. So I'll sing a little chant. Can I get a little music, please? Yeah.
Radhe Radhe Govinda, O Radhe Radhe Govinda.
Which I love, and my secretaries and staff will tell you that this, when they go home, he has something on the staff. I don't know what it is he do or what it is, but when I take his message and put it on the staff, they say when they go home, this chanting remain in the head. They can't get it off at night, but I don't know if it was right in one, but I'll sing chant one. Yeah, you sing it. Lord Shiva. I put you on the spot. He's the master. I just see students.
Hara 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 mahade. Hara hara.
Disha. Disha.
Hara 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 mahade. Hara hara.
Hare 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 Hare
Thank you, Baba. That's not my birthday gift, is it? After that, I'll be there and have to give my one line of my mother's song. But I got to sing one line, I don't know if I write, but you will guide me because you're the master again. Pandanavin. Bhore bhai din chal gaye ambiri maya jay 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 kal kal mandir didi aarti I'm in love with Pandits. Our Pandit Parashram, Tegben Knowledge, our Pandit Abhidhan. Well, he teaches me the love, so I don't know where I'm really going. And then I have Navin to teach me song. So I have three real crackshot men behind me, so I can't go wrong. And this is what my mother teach me. She said, son, you know this other line, it's just truth. I really get all my knowledge from my mother, not from my father. God forbid I say that, but he's the man walking and she's the one I by her foot. And she says, son, in life, stick with the spiritual leaders or spiritual ones, and that is where your guidance and your sense and your knowledge would come. And I took that from the age of 10 years old. Same age would be a bit than 45 and Navin 45, so I know 60, would they say 60, I don't know about that. So you see, we are the guru, and we are three young disciples following him, so where he take, we going, we ain't gonna stop. Sitaram Baba.
Pabloji, I love you. I love you too.
Bole Prem Se Sri Krishnachand Bhagwan Ki Jai. Just a little mantra in memory of all the ancestors. We make prayer to Krishna Bhagwan. Om Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram Hare Hare. Anadhini Dhano Deva Shankha Chakra Gadadhara Akshaya Pundarikaksham Preta Moksha Prado Bhava. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare. Atisi Pushpa Sankasham Pita Basa Samachutam Yena Mastyanti Govindam Nateshan Bindate Bhayam. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare. Hiranyagarbha Purushasya Vyakta Vyakta Sarupini Astya Pritasya Mukshartha Suprito Bhava Sarvada. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama Ram Ram Hare Hare. Sri Krishnachand Bhagavan Ki Jai. And Baba, Pablo Baba created the opportunity for us to be here. So it is the occasion, but you were very delightful. Thank you. I'm sure everybody enjoyed every moment of your time.
Thank you, Babaji. Let's all please stand, my friends, for final arati.
Om Karpura Gauram Karunavataram Sansara Saram Bhujagendraharam Sadava Santam Hridayaravinde Bhavam Bhavani Sahitam Namami. Om Jai Shri Radha Radha Radha. Jai Shri Krishna Krishna Krishna. Shri Radha Krishna Namaha. Shri Radha Krishna.
कृष्णाय नमः।
Krishna, 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 Radha Krishna, Radha Krishna, 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 Kr
मन्त्रहीनं क्रियाहीनं भक्तिहीनं जनार्दन यत्पूजितं मया देव परिपूर्णं तदस्त्वमे
यस्य स्मृत्य जन्मोऽप्याय तपोयज्ञो क्रियातिषु न्यूनं सम्पूर्णतं याति सद्यो वन्दे तमच्युतम् असतो मा
सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योरमामृतम्
Together
त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च च सखा त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव
ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम
May the Basuri of Krishna forever be with us all.
ब्रह्मैव तेन गन्तव्यम् ब्रह्मकर्म समाधिना अहं वैश्वानरो भूत्वा प्राणिनां देहमाश्रितः प्राणापानसमायुक्तः पचाम्यन्नं चतुर्वेदम् ॐ श्री कृष्णार्पणमस्तु प्रेम से बोलिए वृंदावन विहारी लाल की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय आज शक्ति जगदम्बा दुर्गा देवी माता की जय सत्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय गुरु रामानंद स्वामी की जय
हर हर नमः पार्वती पते हर हर महादेव प्रेम से बोलिए सत्य सनातन धर्म की
जय जय सीताराम आसन पर बैठ जाइए माय फ्रेंड्स एट दिस टाइम वी हैव सीमा टू ब्रिंग ग्रीटिंग्स इन अ वेरी सिंपल वे एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट ग्रेटिट्यूड ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द फैमिली सो सीमा जी
सीताराम गुड नाइट ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द रामदेव एंड रूप नारायण फैमिली वी वुड लाइक टू थैंक एवरीवन हियर फॉर जॉइनिंग अस टुनाइट I would also like to invite everyone after to partake in Bhujan. Thank you, Sitaram.
Jai Sitaram and Namaste, everyone.
Join me every Thursday evening at 6:05 p.m. where we sit together like a Hindu family and we do Havan and we listen to bhajan and a short